కరోనా నివారణకు ప్రత్యేకమైన వ్యాక్సిన్ ఔషధాలు ఇంకా అందుబాటులోకి రాలేదని CCMB డైరెక్టర్ రాకేష్ మిశ్రా స్పష్టం చేశారు. అమెరికాలో మాదిరిగా ఇక్కడ వేగంగా ఫలితాలు వచ్చే పరీక్షా కిట్లను తీసుకురావాలని ప్రభుత్వాలకు సూచించారు. CCMBలో రోజుకు 200 నుంచి 300 దాకా పరీక్షలు నిర్వహిస్తున్నామని తెలిపారు. మహమ్మారి కరోనాను ఎదుర్కొనేందుకు భౌతిక దూరం, వ్యక్తిగత శుభ్రత తప్పక పాటించాలని సూచిస్తున్న CCMB డైరెక్టర్ రాకేష్ మిశ్రాతో మా ప్రతినిధి రమ్య ముఖాముఖి.
కరోనా వైరస్ ప్రపంచ దేశాలను వణికిస్తున్న నేపథ్యంలో భారతదేశంలో ముఖ్యంగా తెలంగాణలో ఉన్నటువంటి ఎవరైతే కరోనా సస్పెక్ట్స్ ఉన్నారో వారికి కావాల్సిన పరీక్షలు అందించేందుకు ముందుకొచ్చింది CCMB. ఈ నేపథ్యంలోనే గత కొన్ని రోజులుగా CCMBలో ఈ పరీక్షలు కూడా నిర్వహిస్తున్నారు. మరి ఈ నేపథ్యంలో CCMBలో రోజుకు ఎన్ని పరీక్షలు నిర్వహిస్తున్నారు, ప్రస్తుతం ఏవైనా వ్యాక్సిన్స్ ప్రపంచవ్యాప్తంగా అందుబాటులోకి వచ్చాయని వివరాలు మనకు తెలియజేసేందుకు ప్రస్తుతం మనతో ఉన్నారు CCMB డైరెక్టర్ డాక్టర్ రాకేష్ కే మిశ్రా. మరిన్ని వివరాలు ఆయన మాటలు తెలుసుకుందాం. హలో సార్, ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ very glad to meet you. So how the testings are going on here in CCMB?
Testing is going on well. Now we have earlier we were limited to 200-300, now we can go more, but limitations are of reagents and other supplies that are only approved things can be used, so those are a little bit of limitation, but otherwise we are well set now.
Is government giving you all the reagents and the equipment, or you are procuring that from other countries or other states?
No, all the equipment, CCMB is very well set laboratory. It has all the equipment that are required for testing this virus. And we have a large number of those equipment, so that is not required. But so far, we have not asked government for any equipment what we are using.
Yeah. So since you are doing tests from few days, so how many tests have been done until today, and what is the exact time, and at least the time what is taking for a single test to get the result?
So the test can be done in 5-6 hours. So what happens is, if the sample, one set of samples come now, one come after 2 hours, one comes after 3 hours, so all they have to be, because we want to start with certain number, you can't start with 2 samples and then wait again and do 2 samples. So this logistics take little time, but we try to give the results within 12 to 15 hours, 18 hours. The next day results are given.
Some countries are giving tests in 5 minutes. Is that possible? And if it's possible, then why can't we do that?
Yes, there are tests that can be done in 5 minutes. Those tests are not available in the country. The one company has made the new way of testing. Only in the US those machines are available. Since they are new things, nobody else has that facility, so they cannot do it. There are other antibody-based tests that can be done with fast speed, maybe 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour, and they can be done with less instrument. You don't need big lab facility for that. And we are giving our opinion to the governments, and I think that test will be brought into practice in many states in India as well, the antibody-based test.
So as you mentioned about antibody tests, some countries are, there are some news that some countries are taking antibodies or collecting the serum from the infected person and who are cured from this disease, and they are collecting that serum and trying to do some experiments on that. Is that fact? Is there any possibility in our country to do that?
This is true. So this is not test. So what you are talking about is that if a person has recovered from the infection, that means person has now antibodies, and this antibody persists for 2-3 weeks in the body of the person in large quantities. So if you take a serum blood from the person and isolate the serum, and that plasma is used to inject in another person who is suffering from the virus, it can rescue. Like in many airports, once cargo comes, they don't touch it for 8 hours. But on metallic surfaces like steel, it can stay for much longer. In copper, it stays much less. Most dangerous is plastic. We should avoid touching the plastic which has come into exposure of some other person. And if we touch, no problem, it's not a big deal. The virus will not just pierce through your skin. Go and wash nicely with the soap, you are fine.
So is there any scientific evidence that the kids may be infected very less with this virus?
Yeah. This is general observation that younger people get less infected in many other countries. In India, it's little bit different, that children less than 15-20 are very few that are infected. But younger people are more resistant to the virus because their immune systems are stronger. And even if they get infection, they will come out of it more easily than elderly people. So even though our data now shows countrywide data that lesser number compared to other countries, lesser number of elderly people are infected, but they have to take extreme care in any case.
But there are some news that, or the some assumptions that this coronavirus is also always changing its structure. It's like mutating its structure. Is that fact? Is there any scientific evidence for that?
All coronavirus, all viruses of this family have this characteristic that they mutate very fast. That is the reason we don't have any proper vaccine or very strong drug against common flu.
So what about the vaccination? There are some speculations that some kind of vaccinations are useful to prevent this corona. Is that fact?
I don't think there is any vaccine available today which has been proven to be effective against coronavirus.
So what the message you want to give for the people to prevent or to not to have any contact with the COVID?
It is spread from person to person. So if you prevent that, you don't touch anything which you think others may have touched or others may have come close contact or sneeze or coughed on this. If they have done that, don't be afraid. Just go and wash your hand with the soap and you are just fine. And when you are in a crowded place, when you are close to some other person whom you do not know, wear mask. They are required also for healthcare workers who need it more.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ సో దీనికి సంబంధించిన రీసెర్చెస్ అయితే జరుగుతున్నాయని చెప్పి ముఖ్యంగా ఎవరైతే ఎఫెక్ట్ అయ్యి దాని నుంచి కోలుకున్న వారున్నా దానికి సంబంధించిన సీరంని తీసుకొని ప్రస్తుతం అంటే ఎవరైతే కోవిడ్తో బాధపడుతున్నారో వాళ్ళకి కనుక ఇచ్చి ప్యాసివ్ ఈ క్యూరేషన్ కోసం కూడా ప్రయత్నాలు జరుగుతున్నాయని చెప్పేసి మరోవైపు సీసీఎంబీ కూడా దీనికి అవసరం అన్ని ప్రయత్నాలు చేస్తున్నామని చెప్పేసి ఇక టెస్టులకు సంబంధించిన పూర్తి స్థాయిలో సహకారం అందిస్తామని చెప్తున్నారు సీసీఎంబీ డైరెక్టర్ డాక్టర్ రాకేష్ కే మిశ్రా కెమెరా పర్సన్ రమణ మహేష్తో రమ్య ఈటీవీ న్యూస్ హైదరాబాద్.